Hi, welcome back. Today we are reviewing one of the pens that we recently received, sent to us by Monte Grappa for review purposes. This is the Monte Grappa Heartwood Pier. This is one of three pens that compose the Heartwood collection, along with the Walnut and the Teak. This pen comes inside this traditional Monte Grappa box made by a blue sleeve that has inside this blue cardboard box with the Monte Grappa pattern engraved, and this opens to reveal the actual pen case, which is this kind of leather box with this pattern engraved in it and this silver label with Monte Grappa written on it. Inside, what do we have? We have we have the pen, which is in a tray, and under this tray there are two Monte Grappa cartridges and a booklet about the pen. So let's look at the pen. Let's focus this closer. What do we have to say about the pen? The pen has the same. This design is based on the Fortuna model, and it is the same kind of design that we can find on the Monte Grappa Mule fountain pen that we reviewed some time ago. You can see it here. It has the same size, the same overall design. This is much heavier because it's made of copper, but it's the same model, different kind of materials, but the same kind of pen. So, the pen, the cap and barrel are made of ear wood, and this has this reddish tone to it, and you can see the wood grain. The metallic elements on this pen have a brushed bronze finish. Let's try to see it closer. As you can see, it is kind of a brushed bronze finish. Here we have Monte Grappa engraved in cursive. We have the typical logo with 1912 on the top of the cap, and then we have a very very stiff nib that has this little wheel on the end of it to allow to the pen to slip easily into a pocket because of this sleeve and because the clip is so tight. What we have more to say? The cap on this pen, it fits as a screw fit. When we take off the cap, we can see we have a section of brushed bronze color, just as the metallic elements on the cap. And the nib, it is a steel nib with this bronze color, and it has the same Monte Grappa pattern that is also engraved on the box, as you can see. This is a fine nib. The F is down there, and this is the typical Fortuna fountain pen nib. Then the section unscrews from the barrel to show a converter that is a screw fit into the section so it won't fall off easily. And inside this pen you can use either the converter or one long international cartridge, or one short international cartridge here and another one stored inside just when first, just as a backup. The pen is an FNIB and this is quite a nice pen. So let's just see how this pen performs. The paper is the Rodia boat pad. The pen is the Monte Grappa. Sorry, Heartwood Pier. And the ink is Parker Quink Brown. About the ink, we should notice that we started testing this pen with the Monte Grappa Brown, which is a beautiful color, but it is somehow a darker, drier ink, and we noticed that the flow on this pen, it was not enough to write well, and we had to be constantly priming the feed, squeezing the converter. With this ink, which is much wetter, it doesn't happen. And with this, the nib is perfect. What do we have to say about the nib? This is a Monte Grappa fine nib, and the fine nibs by Monte Grappa are always on the finer side. So they are more like an F nib from an Asian pen than from an European pen, which is nice. We love fine pens. No problem about that, but we need to have a wetter ink to make the nib perform very well. About this pen, this ink is performs well in this pen. The nib is a steel nib. You can have some line variation with some pressure, but not really too much. The nib is not a scratchy nib, but you can hear some noise. It's not that bad, but it's not scratchy. It's very, very, very smooth, but it has a special kind of feedback. It has, I would say, it has the Monte Grappa feedback. Not unpleasant at all, but we can feel it. And we believe this happens because it's really a fine nib, so it's impossible to be a very, very, very smooth nib. This pen has a very nice performance. The nib is made of steel. With this ink, it puts down a decent amount of ink, and the feed behaves perfectly. About the pen, this pen is a very light pen because it's made of wood, of a light wood, but because the section is made of metal, it is very well balanced, so there's no effort at all to hold the pen. If you put the cap here, if you post the cap, it doesn't become unbalanced, but it's much more comfortable to use without the cap posted, because the cap is a little bulky and has these metal, three metal elements that make some weight of it on it. Overall, this is really a good pen. You could easily write novel with this. It's very classy pen made of wood. It doesn't look cheap at all. Some kit pens that can turn the barrel out of wood. It's really well made, and it is a good addition to the whole collection that we can see here. Sorry, this is the pure wood pen. This is the walnut, which has a more brown tone to it, not as red as the pure pen. And then we have the teak, which for me is the nicest of these three pens, because it has a very dark wood, almost black, and there's a beautiful contrast between this almost black wood, and you can see almost no wood grain, and there's a nice contrast between this and the metallic elements. These are three fine pens. We have to thank Montegrappa for sending us the pen. We have also to thank you for being there watching for your videos. And I hope you enjoyed this review. Soon we'll publish the full length written review on our blog. If you enjoyed the video, please subscribe our YouTube channel. It will be really important for us to keep us going. See you next time. Bye.